Hi, Squirts. My name is Auntie M, and welcome to Auntie M's Reading Time. And today, we are going to be reading Mike's Dirty, Yucky, Icky, Sticky Adventure by Justine Corman Fontes, illustrated by Rebecca Thornburg. Mike didn't want to take a bath. He never wanted to take a bath. "Why can't I just stay dirty?" he asked. "Because dirt carries germs that might make you sick," Mom explained. "Who cares about something you can't even see?" Mike grumbled. "We do," his father said firmly. "Now get spreading." Mike sighed. Suddenly, the tub started twirling faster and faster. And when it stopped, Mike found himself in a strange and sticky land. "What is this place?" Mike wondered. He heard laughter and saw a bunch of ragged-looking children throwing mud pies. They were dirty from their matted hair to their bare, blackened toes. "Let's go to the sponge swamp," the biggest one shouted. "My name is Mike," said Mike. "Can I come too?" The children introduced themselves as Grubby, Stinky, and Trash. They were so dirty, Mike could barely tell them apart. "Squish!" Grubby cried as he plunged into the muggy swamp. "Yippee!" Stinky shouted. Mike jumped into the ooshy-gooshy, smelly swamp of damp sponges. The sponges had been used to wipe up spills and dirt where their perfect homes for germs. When they grew bored of the sponge swamp, Mike, Stinky, Grubby, and Trash rolled down dirty dish rag hill. Mike tumbled over and over on the sticky slope of the damp dish rags. The hill stayed forever cold because it lay in the shadow of the great mud mountain, and it was very moldy because of the invisible germs grew in the dark. "This is fun!" Mike cried. But playing tag through the nasty bath towel forest was even more fun. Mike and the others raced through the jungle of stinky bath towels, laughing and shouting. Mike had never been so dirty in his life. Little did he know that dirty bath towels sometimes contain nasty germs. "Let's take Mike to Grimeland," Grubby suggested. Stinky agreed. "It's the dirtiest place in the whole kingdom of Grud." Soon the children found themselves in Grimeland. They twirled around and around on the unmade beds of the messy merry-go-round and rode the funky Ferris wheel over and over. All that fun made them hungry, and so the filthy friends went to the disgusting diner where mud pies were always on the menu. Mike looked around. People coughed and sneezed without covering their mouths. They shared silverware, glasses, and crusty cloth napkins. They ate with dirty hands. Mike wasn't sure he liked this. "I need to go to the bathroom before I eat," Mike said. As Mike was going to the bathroom door, Trash was leaving. "Are you going to wash your hands after using the bathroom?" Mike asked. Trash laughed. "Oh, you're such a kidder. I could never get away with that at home," Mike said. Suddenly, Mike felt like he was going to sneeze. "Have you got a tissue?" he asked Trash. "No, we don't like those here," Trash said. Mike was confused. "You don't use tissues?" Trash nodded. "Or paper towels? Toilet paper? Soap?" Mike shouted. He couldn't believe it. "So how do you keep your hands clean?" Mike was beginning to feel dizzy and sick. But sick from what? The sponges he swam in? The dish rags and towels he tumbled in? The messy merry-go-round he touched? He couldn't wait to go home and get clean. The kingdom of Crud was everything he thought he'd ever wanted, but this adventure had changed his mind. Suddenly, Mike couldn't hold a sneeze in. Choo! Mike's head spun like a top. Suddenly, Mike realized he was back at home in the bathroom. He wasn't sick after all. And there was plenty of tissues, toilet paper, soap, and paper towels in the very nice clean bathroom. He scrubbed himself happily. "What's gotten over you, Mike?" Mike's mom exclaimed. Dad was amazed. "He's so clean." "Germs can be pretty nasty, Dad, so I clean myself up," Mike said. Mike's mom and dad exclaimed that not all germs are bad. "Sure, there are nasty germs, Mike," Dad said, "but there are also a lot of good germs." "That's right," Mom said. "Some germs help make the food we eat, some protect us from the infections, and some live in our bodies to help digest the food we eat. The secret is to avoid the bad germs, like those found in garbage, rotting food, and animal and human waste, which can make you very sick," Mike's dad exclaimed. Mike finally understood why his parents had made such a fuss about being clean. Being dirty and sick was no fun, and neither was living in the kingdom of God. In fact, from that day on, Mike was a changed boy. He didn't mind washing his hands after playing outside, petting his dog, or using the toilet, and he was careful not to spread germs. Mike didn't even mind taking baths. "Being clean beats getting sick any day," became Mike's motto. Mike was even prepared to help protect all of his friends from the kingdom of greed. All right, thank you, Squirts, for coming in and listening to me today. I will see you next time. Bye.